designated player, number 42, Savannah Fisher. Third base, number 12, Emma Dargie. Left field, number 26, Faith Romero. Center field, number 4, Jessica Nelson. First base, number 23, Crystal Hoplow. Shortstop, number 3, Haley Parks. Second base, number 1, Emily Klosterman. And the starting pitcher for the Mavericks, left-hander, number 6, Omri Hackney. Positions for the Mavericks are Ryan Wondrasek, Ruben Carrera, and Danny Goff, and the coach, Jay Sanchez. Your umpires for this team, Jim Dooley, Jason Smith, and Dan Rogers.
Welcome to game number 5 of the Summit League Softball Tournament here on day number two. Game number 3 of day number 2, but game number 5 of the tournament as a whole, featuring the Omaha Mavericks and the Fort Wayne Mastodons, and it is an elimination game. Winner will go on to face the winner of NDSU-SDSU tomorrow, and the loser will be going home. Omaha coming in as a favorite. They are the 5 seed going up against the 6 seed Fort Wayne. How did each of these teams get here? That's a good question. I'll answer it for you right here. Opening round yesterday, Fort Wayne got a win over Western Illinois 9-3. They beat the Leathernecks and moved onto the winner's bracket, sent Western Illinois home, but then lost 8-0 just a few moments ago. They got beat by South Dakota State 8-0 in 6 innings, so Fort Wayne ends up here on the loser's side of the bracket. South Dakota, well, it was actually them and Omaha facing off in day number 1, and Omaha got the victory 8-5, pardon me, as a final in that first game. 8-5 final, Omaha beating South Dakota. They moved on and faced North Dakota State earlier today, and the Bison with a 9-0 victory over Omaha sent Omaha into this loser-go-home situation. First pitch here, first inning, a ground ball to short, and out recorded at first base, grounding out there for Fort Wayne. Leading them off is Lacey Wilsbacher. A quick out here in the first for the Mastodons. That's what each team got here today. NDSU and SDSU both advanced. They will face each other tomorrow at 1 p.m. The winner of that game gets a spot in the championship. Won't have to lose twice to lose the tournament. And the winner, or the loser tomorrow, will have to fight their way through in a play-in game for the championship tomorrow at 3:30. In the circle for Omaha, freshman of the year, Aubrey Hackey. Hackey pitched yesterday and picked up the win for Omaha. Falls behind 2-1. Here to Lauren Watson. And that one will be caught after it rolls through the infield for a one-out single. Lauren Wilson finds herself on first with one out in the inning. And that's going to bring up Demetra Burns. Batting order here in the elimination game for Fort Wayne, their second game of the day. Lacey Wilsbacher bats first. Lauren Watson in the two spot. Demetra Burns here batting third. Cleanup hitter, Maria Palmigiani. Morgan Denny going to bat fifth as this one's hit down the right field line, but a little twist foul. Morgan Denny bats fifth, will play third. Stephanie Hannock, the designated player, will bat in the sixth spot. Jenna Balthazor bats seventh. Courtney Holm will bat eighth. And Brooke Immel will round out the order, batting ninth. Bailey Benefield will be in the circle here today for Fort Wayne. Picked up a complete game victory in their win against Western Illinois yesterday. 0-1 pitch, left up high. Evens the count at 1-1. And on that one, we saw Demetra Burns square up like she wanted a bunt. Burns a .284 hitter on the season. 1-1 count, pitch, fouled back, and out of play. Be 1-2. Hackey winds and delivers to Burns. That one down and away. Two balls and two strikes. Evens up the count. Burns, a 284 hitter with 12 runs scored, 21 runs batted in. Does have four home runs on the season. The 2-2, taken low. Ball three fills the count. She's only walked seven times this year, has struck out 19. Payoff pitch, swung on and hit hard towards third. Back over to first, and a double play. A snag by Dargy at third. Quick throw across the diamond to Pablo at first, and they double off Watson. One hit, nobody left, and no runs after our first half inning of play. Mavericks coming to bat, all tied up at zeros. Leading off the bottom of the first inning for Omaha will be Natalie Mostick. Batting order for DJ Sanchez and the Omaha Mavericks looks like this. Mostick will lead things off as she takes ball one off the inside corner from Bailey Benefield. Mostick bats first. Freshman of the year, Aubrey Hackey, will bat second. Kelly Patterson bats in the three spot, followed by Savannah Fisher batting fourth, cleanup duty. Emma Dargy will bat fifth. Faith Romero bats sixth. Jessica Nelson will bat seventh. Crystal Pablo and Haley Bartz will round out the order for the Omaha Mavericks. They're going up against second team All-Summit League pitcher Bailey Benefield. Complete game in the win yesterday for Fort Wayne. Gave up three runs to a very good Western Illinois team. Benefield behind, two balls, no strikes here to Mostick. A 2-0 pitch inside. Now three balls and no strikes. Benefield coming into this game, 12-13 overall record. One save, 171 and a third innings pitched. 139 strikeouts. More than a strikeout, or more than half a strikeout per inning. Not quite one per inning. Gives up a walk here. That is her 67th walk surrendered on the year. Puts Mostick over on first and brings up Aubrey Hackey. Hackey, your freshman of the year. First pitch from Benefield. Hackey squaring around and pulls the bat back. Takes ball one up high. And Palmigiani going to call for time and walk out to Benefield. Talk things over here. Calm down the pitcher. Something again, Palmigiani great offensively, but something you got to do as a catcher. Control the pitchers in the circle. And even though Palmigiani is just a sophomore and you got Bailey Benefield, who's a senior out there, going out there just to calm her down, give her some advice, try to get her back into the strike zone here. A leadoff walk, and now falling behind Hackey, one ball, no strikes. Season on the line for both of these teams. It's the second game of the day for both of them as well. 1-0 pitch, on the way. That one finds the strike zone, evens it up 1-1. Field toes the rubber, winds and fires the 1-1, just misses the outside corner as Hackey pulled the bat back again. Two balls and one strike. Ryan Wondrasik, coach over at third base. DJ Sanchez, the head coach of the Mavericks. Jermaine Fairchild, head coach for the Fort Wayne Mastodons. And Hackey lines one into left or the right field. Picked up there by Balthazar. Got back in quickly, but Mostek will advance over to third on the single by Aubrey Hackey. Hit that one pretty sharp on the nose past Demetra Burns at first.
Right fielder, number 30.
And the Mavericks with a serious threat here in inning number one. Brings up Kelly Patterson, the right fielder. Passing a very dangerous hitter, 398 average. With seven home runs, seven doubles, 33 RBIs on the season. First pitch is ball one. Do you want to watch Hackey? Good speed at first. No stolen bases, though, on the year. Mostek, however, eight stolen bases. Use that speed to get over from first to third on that single. And a bunt back to Benefield. She's going to go home with it. The throw home. Not in time. Mostek going to get the first run across here of the day. Omaha takes a 1-0 lead. The bunt right back to Benefield. Looked like she maybe didn't know exactly what she wanted to do with it right away. Could have thrown the first, got the force out there. Mostek was off. As that ball hit the bat, she came home. Benefield hesitated just a second. It's a good throw to Pomigiani, but just a little bit late, and that allowed Mostek to sneak in at home. Hackey also moves over to second. Patterson now over on first. Won't get credit with a hit. It'll be a fielder's choice, but she will get credit with the RBI. Pitch here is bunted back and up against the screen. As Fisher now up, try to bunt that one. Savannah Fisher, the junior cleanup hitter, designated player for the Mavericks here today. So in that last play where Patterson laid down the bunt, she reaches on a fielder's choice. Hackey advanced to second. Mostek scored on an error by the catcher. As it was obstruction, that was the signal from our home plate umpire. This one's a pop-up in foul territory, in play, but not caught. Might have she gone into the dugout. Wilsbacher, the shortstop, was over there. She was calling for it. Kind of lost her. She got behind the dugout, from my view. No balls and two strikes here to Fisher. So they called obstruction by Pomigiani trying to block the plate. So there's an error on the catcher, Maria Pomigiani. Don't know if they would have had the out at home anyways, but called obstruction. So that's how the run gets in. 1-0 Omaha. Runners first and second, nobody out. Savannah Fisher, who has five home runs and 22 RBIs on the season, up. She hits one on the ground, slowly to second. They'll flip to second for one, back to first, a double play. Good work there by the Mastodons middle infielders. Lauren Watson got the slow roller, flipped it to Wilsbacher in time to get Patterson, and over to first in time to get Fisher. Doesn't run down the line the quickest on the team. Now two outs. Hackey will advance over to third and will be left up to Emma Dargie. Dargie made the great play to end the top of the first, caught the liner right to her at third base and threw to first to convert the double play. Each team turned in a double play here in the first inning. No balls and one strike to Dargie. Pitch on its way, left up high. Evens the count up at 1-1. Dargie on the season, a .252 average. 16 RBIs on the season. Six doubles, a triple, and six home runs. And the 1-1 inside. Good block by Palmigiani. Keeping that one in front of her and keeping Hackey at third base. The 2-1 on its way, and that one left up high. He's at three balls and one strike. Three-one count to Dargie. Romero on deck. 3-1 hit well out towards left center. That one's back past the wall and gone. Two-run home run for Emma Dargie. And Omaha out to a 3-0 lead. Dargie with her seventh home run of the season. That one just about straight away center field over the North Dakota State University sign out there in center. And over the head of Brooke Immel out in center field. Home run and a Maverick strike for at least three here in the first. Home run number seven and RBIs 17 and 18 on the season for Dargie. Also scores her 19th run of the season. Now 2 outs and nobody on. We'll bring up Faith Romero. Romero with a good swing on the first one, follows it straight back to the screen. And Bailey Benefield, who threw a complete game, only giving up 3 runs, never gave up more than 1 run in any inning to Western Illinois yesterday. He's given up 3 here in the first to Omaha. The 0-1 to Romero, swung on and fisted just past the arm of Benefield. Now bobbled there by Watson, but plenty of time as Romero wasn't running hard out of the box. Thought that one might have been caught by Benefield, and then Benefield reached for it, wasn't able to come up with it. But Watson does retire Romero for the third out of the inning. But 3 runs, including a 2-run home run by Dargie. It's a 3-0 lead after inning number one for the Omaha Mavericks. Top of the second, Fort Wayne finds themselves down three early and trying to start something here in the second with their cleanup batter, catcher Maria Palmigiani, second team All-Summit League selection. Palmigiani takes up and away, ball one from Aubrey Hackey, working with a three-run lead now. The 1-0 inside makes it two balls and no strikes. Two-0 misses as well, so now three balls, no strikes here to Palmigiani. Hackey pitched the first four innings yesterday against USD, gave up four runs, was relieved as Sydney Hampton came in. Hampton picked up the win, going three innings with no runs given up. No strikeouts yesterday for Hackey. It's a strike here, three balls and one strike now to Palmigiani. It'll be Maria, then Morgan Denny, and Stephanie Hannock. First three batters here in Fort Wayne's half of the second, a 3-1. And a five-pitch walk puts Maria Palmigiani over on first base. And you never like leadoff walks, but especially after your team's put you up three runs. The last half inning, you want to come out here to throw strikes and get your team back in the dugout. Instead, Hackey with the leadoff walk, and now Palmigiani over on first, and Morgan Denny will come up to the plate. Take strike one. So far this season, Hackey, a 5-8 record. 98 innings pitched. Throws a ball here, evens up the count 1-1 to Denny. 98 and a third innings pitched. He's given up 65 runs. Does have 47 strikeouts and 38 walks. A 1-1. Swing and a miss from Denny. Now one ball and two strikes. Hackey with an ERA of 4.67. Making start number 12 on the year. Does have three complete games this year for the Mavericks in her freshman season. The 1-2 hit pretty sharply over the second baseman, Klosterman, and into right field. Patterson corrals it there, gets it back into the infield, holds Palmigiani at second, but back-to-back runners reach here to start the second inning for Fort Wayne. Now DJ Sanchez will come out of the dugout and visit her freshman in the circle. And Sanchez leaves the circle after meeting with Hackey and the rest of the infield. Looks like Jermaine Fairchild is going to make a change here as well. Going to pull Palmigiani off the base pads, putting a pinch runner for her. I'm sure she'll come check back in defensively in the bottom half of the second. Pinch runner, though, for Fort Wayne. Will be number two, Peyton Hollis. Stephanie Hannock up to bat for the Mastodons. Peyton Hollis, a junior from Lebanon, Indiana. Pinch running at second base. First pitch to Hannock. Inside, ball one from Hackey. A 1-0 delivery now here from Hackey. Swung on and missed. Hack maybe got just a piece of that one. One and one to Hannock. A couple of big hits already for the Mastodons in this tournament from Stephanie Hannock. Takes ball two outside there, though. Had that three RBI double in day one against Western Illinois that gave Fort Wayne the eventual win. Now heading the count 2-1. The pitch on its way outside. Evens it up. Makes the count now 3-1. Well ahead in the count. Chance here to get the first three runners or batters on in the top half of the second. Balthazar waiting on deck. 3-1. On the outside corner. Hackey gets the strike call. On a full count. Three balls, two strikes. Payoff pitch on the way, fouled back, and out of play. We'll do it once again. Another 3-2 on its way. That one is up and away. Another walk from Hackey, her second this inning. Now she's loaded the bases with nobody out and a serious threat here for Fort Wayne. Jenna Balthazar will come up now. Balthazar takes the ball. So Hackey having some trouble with the strike zone here in inning number two. Has 139 walks on the season and 98 innings pitched. The 1-0 pitch on its way, and that one is on the outside corner. Gets the strike call, evens it up 1-1. Balthazar, the right fielder, 244 average, is making her 91st at-bat of the season. Has 15 RBI, 16 runs scored. Follows this one straight back to the net. He's drawn 11 walks and struck out 23 times. Has six doubles, no triples, but two home runs on the year. One, two, pitch on its way. Popped up in the air down to the third baseline. It's going to be foul, but also going to be caught. Dargie's over there, makes the catch to retire Balthazar. That's the first out of the inning, and no one can move up. I'll bring up Courtney Holm now. First pitch to Holm is a soft one. Very soft hit liner over towards Dargie. Dargie makes that catch. Now two outs in the inning. Can be left up to Brooke Immel. Bases were loaded with nobody out. A couple of pop-ups over to third. And now Immel, the number nine batter, needs a big two-out hit for Fort Wayne. First pitch to her. Off the outside corner, one ball, no strikes. Emma went 0-2 in their first game today, but had a huge game in their first game of the tournament yesterday against Western Illinois. Reached four times, the 1-0. On the inside corner, 1-1. One from Hackey to Immel. Swung on out towards left, but going to be just shy of the outfield on the edge of the infield dirt. That one's caught by Bartz. And they had bases loaded and nobody out, but a great work by the freshman Aubrey Hackey in the circle. Strands three runners, and after the top of the second, we'll go to the bottom of the second inning with Omaha leading 3-0, and the Mavericks coming to bat. Yo! Bottom of the second. We'll start things off with the number seven batter, Jessica Nelson, center fielder for the Mavericks. It'll be the 7, 8, 9 hitters here for Omaha. Nelson, Crystal Pablo, batting eighth. And then Haley Bartz, number nine batter, will round out the first three here for the Mavericks. First pitch into Nelson off the inside outside corner for ball one. And Bailey Benenfield hoping for a quicker second inning. Used 20 pitches in the first. Gave up three runs. Ball two, left up just high. Two balls and no strikes. The leadoff batter here for the Mavericks. Benefield winds and delivers a 2-0. That one hit her. Nope, hit the bat. Tough from the way Nelson reacted. It didn't seem like it hit her. She wasn't wincing or anything. Seemed like it might have hit the bat. That's exactly what's called from our home plate umpire, Jim Bewley. Jim behind the plate today. Jason Smith over at first, along with Dan Rogers, the other. Our three-man crew today. 2-1 pitch now from Benefield. Swing and a miss from Nelson. Well up in front of that one. Benefield dropped a drop ball right on the outside there. Nelson on the season has struck out 20 times. Here's the 2-2. That one's softly hit towards third. Charging is Denny. Throw to first. In time. A good stretch at first by Demetra Burns. And retiring Nelson for the first out of the inning. Crystal Pablo going to come up now. So she'll bat in the number seven, or number eight spot in this lineup for DJ Sanchez. First pitch to Pablo, left up high from Benefield. One ball, no strikes. On the season, Pablo, just a 181 average. Again, her 73rd at-bat of the season. 13 hits, scored three runs, batted in nine, and has drawn eight walks and walked 19 times. Two home runs and a double. On the season, her three extra base hits. Another 1-1 from Benefield. Swung on, out towards right. And back there to make the catch is Lauren Watson. Shallow right field near the foul line. A long run for Watson, but got there in time and makes a nice catch. Pablo is the second out of the inning. Bring up Haley Bartz. Bartz now will swing and fouls one down the third baseline. Starting second baseman Emily Klosterman, not in the batting order. She's replaced by the designated player Savannah Fisher. Bartz starting up the middle with Klosterman though. Bartz starts at shortstop. 0-1 delivery. left up high. One ball and one strike. A 1-1 hit pretty well out towards left, but going to twist, just foul. Then one ball and two strikes here to Higley Bartz, batting third, nobody on. Two outs, 3-0 lead here for Omaha. The 2-0 pitch, or the 1-2 pitch. Misses for ball two. Benefield gets the sign. Looks to the catcher and delivers the 2-2 offering. Swung on. Into foul territory and out of play. Lands before Baltazar can get over there, along with Lauren Watson, both making a bid for it. We'll have another 2-2 pitch. Benefield to Bartz. Swung on, hit in the air to center. Shallow center field. In for it is Immel. She'll make the catch. And a 1-2-3 inning for Bailey Benefield. We'll go to the top of the third. It's Omaha 3, Fort Wayne nothing. The top of the order here for the Fort Wayne Mastodons, trailing 3-0, going to the top of the third. Lacey Wilsbacher will start things off. Wilsbacher takes ball one from Aubrey Hockey. Hockey, rather. Pitch to the outside, makes it two balls and no strikes from Hockey. First time up, Wilsbacher with the ground ball back to the shortstop, Bartz. Pitch. Up under the arm. This makes it three balls and no strikes. And one thing Hackey has struggled with so far, it has been her command. A couple of walks through the first two innings. A 3-0, and that is a four-pitch walk to put the leadoff runner on aboard here. In inning number three. Second time in three innings, Mastodons have had their leadoff runner on. Now with Wilsbacher on over at first, we'll bring up Lauren Watson. Watson with a single up the middle, her first time up. First pitch is a ball. One ball, no strikes. It's Wilsbacher, Watson, and Burns, the first three up, and Fort Wayne's open for a few more up here in their half of the third. Dargy well in on third, expecting the bunt or a slap the other way just like that to short. Picked up by Bartstor across the diamond in time. Good strong throw from the shortstop position that time. With Bartz all the way across over to Crystal Pablo. Gets the first out of the inning. Wilsbacher will advance over to second. Haley Bartz with a strong throw from the shortstop position. Gets the out there, and that'll bring up Demetra Burns. And this one popped up in the air into right field. Caught there by Pattison. And Burns gone on one pitch. Wilsbacher cannot advance. It'll be two outs. And Wilsbacher over on second. The cleanup batter, the catcher, Maria Palmigiani. Palmigiani, the sophomore catcher, 6'2". From Surrey, British Columbia. First pitch, misses for ball one. One ball and no strikes to Palmigiani. Pitch on its way. And that one is on the outside corner. Evens the count at 1-1. Denny on deck. My base open for Palmigiani. Don't expect Hackett to give her too much to hit here, but it doesn't take much of a mistake for Palmigiani to really be able to jump all over it. The 1-1. Swings at that one. Grounds to short. Picked up by Bartz. Throwing to first. And in time to retire Maria Palmigiani and the Mastodons here in inning number three. Three scoreless innings tossed by the freshman Aubrey Hockey so far. And going to the bottom of the third, it's 3-0. Omaha. Yeah. Omaha looking to add to their 3-0 lead. They'll start with the top of the order. Natalie Mostick will come up. Mostick, the catcher on this Maverick squad. First pitch inside, ball one from Benefield. I will say to my left, Omaha has had someone kind of warming up over in the bullpen-ish area for just about the whole game, just keeping them loose. It looks like it might be Hampton again. Fort Wayne, I don't know if they'd send anyone down to that same area, which is on the Omaha side. If they'd had someone go back behind their dugout, which I can't see from my vantage point, but I don't see anyone warming up for Fort Wayne. And Benefield is obviously, as you would say, the ace of their staff, second team All-Summit League selection. So this is really her game to win or lose for Fort Wayne. And so far down 3-0. Mavericks got those three in the first, and Benefield kind of in charge of putting up some zeros here from here on out and giving her chance her team a chance to come back and score some runs for her. 2-1 count here to Mostick. It'll be Mostick, Hackey, and Pattison. First three up here for the Mavericks. They're the ones that did some damage back in the first. Mostick reached on a walk. 2-1 delivery. Mostick squares around, then pulls it back and takes ball three. And a lot of 3-1 counts today for Bailey Benefield. Three-one on its way. That's a swing and foul towards the bullpen area. Caught by the netty. Fills the count up at 3-2 here to Mostick. He's already scored a run here today with that walk. Rips this one foul over the bullpen area towards the parking lot. I'll do another payoff pitch. This one grounded towards third. Denny comes up with the play. And a throw over to first. 3-2 pitch grounded to the third baseman, Denny. Morgan Denny comes up, makes the play, throws it across there to Burns for out number one. I'll bring up Aubrey Hackey. With one out in the inning and nobody on. First pitch on its way from Benefield. One ball, no strikes. The 1-0 on its way. That's going to make it 2-0. Again, outside, and Benefield working from behind here once again. Two balls and no strikes. There was a play, forgot to mention this during the second inning, but after the first, where Faith Romero had to last out that little kind of pop-up in the infield. It's a bunt attempt by Hackey, comes up empty on it. Two balls, one strike. Benefield, we don't try and grab that pop-up by Romero, but it just got out of her reach, and then Lauren Watson picked it up, threw it over to first. They got the out, kind of a nondescript play, but on that play, Benefield kind of looked like she jammed a wrist or jammed a finger or something. She was down for a little while, got back up, and was okay as Hackey lines this one up the middle, but a nice catch by Wilsbacher at shortstop, moving to her left, getting the glove up and making the catch. Hackey putting some good bat on ball there, her second. Good contact. Second time up with some good contact on the ball, but comes up empty-handed that time. The Benefield stayed down for a little while after that play in the first inning. She might knocked something around and jammed a finger maybe, but was okay. Was able to get off the field just fine and looks to be all right. I always wonder if something like that in the cold weather, still, it's kind of breezy. We're in the 50s. And it's been a lot colder in Fargo-Moorhead in the distant past, but it still doesn't feel super warm out there, and those little jammed fingers tend to hurt a little bit more in weather like this. No balls and one strike. Now to Kelly Pattison, who's up here with two outs and nobody on. Benefield delivers to Pattison, who flies one out to deep center. That one's back near the wall and gone. A two-out solo home run for Kelly Pattison. That makes it 4-0 Mavericks. Pattison with her trip around the bases hit that one out to basically straight away center over the Bison logo there, kind of left center of the outfield. And Pattison hits her eighth home run of the year. And it's a 4-0 lead now for the Omaha Mavericks. Patterson's eighth home run. It's also her 34th RBI on the year. Both of those are team leading in those categories. Most RBIs and most home runs on the team now. Was tied with Natalie Mostek at 7 home runs apiece. Now has the lead there. And now very first pitch to Savannah Fisher is kind of muscled out to center over Wilsbacher's head. And be a single with 2 outs here for Savannah Fisher. 2 outs and 1 on now for Emma Dargy, who will come up. Dargy already a successful day at the plate. There's 1-for-1 with 2 RBIs as she hit a 2-run home run back in inning number 1. That was out to about the same exact spot that Patterson just hit hers. Pitch from Benefield. Swung on, took something off of that one and got Dargy well out in front. No balls and 1 strike. Benefield will wind and delivers. That one inside makes it 1-1. Fisher over on first. 1 stolen base in 1 attempt so far this season. A 1-1 delivery. Left up high, 2 balls and 1 strike. If Dargy were to reach, Faith Romero is on deck. The 2-1 off the inside corner makes it 3 balls and 1 strike. Now Benefield in danger of walking her second batter this inning. A 3-1 count and the pitch on its way. Clips the inside corner. Now fills the count up. 3 balls and 2 strikes. Payoff pitch from Benefield on its way. Swung on, hit out towards right. It's going to be foul, but would it be caught? No, a sliding effort by Balthazar out there in right down the line. Comes up empty-handed. We'll have another payoff pitch here to Dargy. Fisher still standing at first after that two-run home run by, or solo home run, rather, by Kelly Patterson. It's made it 4-0 here for the Mavericks. Bottom of the third. The 3-2 swung on, and that's going to be fouled on the third baseline. A little pop up. A good fight here from Emma Dargy. Plays third base for the Mavericks. Dargy, a sophomore from La Vista, Nebraska. Stands in at 5'6". Takes another 3-2. Followed straight back again. Have another payoff pitch. And senior Benefield not wanting to give in to the sophomore. Sophomore not wanting to give in to the senior. Three balls, 2 strikes. Benefield rocks and delivers. That one's hit out towards left. That will drop for a hit. Good cutoff, though, by Holm out there in left. Digging for a third is Fisher. The throw to third, not in time. Gets away from Denny for a second. It's going to allow Dargy to advance to second. And Emma Dargy, another big hit here with 2 outs. Rips the single into left. Aggressive base running by Fisher got herself to third, and on that throw towards third, allows Dargy to advance over to second base. Now two runners in scoring position, still two outs, and Faith Romero will come up with a chance to really break this one open here for the Mavericks. First time up for Romero, grounded out to Lauren Watson. First pitch to her is outside, ball one, and Bailey Benefield has already thrown 47 pitches through 2 2/3 innings. That was pitch 48. Here comes pitch number 49, one ball, no strikes. Romero, 200 average, batting 138 with two outs in an inning. Swings and misses on that one. 114 with runners in scoring position, so not great in these scenarios. Does have two home runs on the year, along with a double. Really, any hit to the outfield should score for sure, Fisher. And you would think Dargy would be sent as well, unless it's a really sharply hit single to one of the corner outfielders. Nine RBIs on the year for Romero. I'd like to get the double digits here. 1-1. Swung on out towards right. I think it's going to twist foul. It will, and too far of a run for Balthazar. Balthazar out there in right field. One ball and two strikes. Romero will come back to the plate. This one's popped up, packed, and thrown over to first, and will be out number three. Romero, and they'll come up with the clutch two-out hit, but one more run does come in. Home run by Kelly Patterson, and three of the four runs so far for the Mavericks coming by way of the long ball after three innings of play. It's a 4-0 lead for Omaha over Fort Wayne. Someone get me a water. Yeah. I don't have a big equipment. Ball number one to Morgan Denny, leading off the top of the fourth inning here for Fort Wayne, trailing 4-0. It'll be Denny, Hanick, and Balthazar, the first three to come up here for Fort Wayne. Takes ball number two. Two balls and one strike. Now the count here to Denny. First time up, hit a single to right center field. This one's popped up towards center, hanging up in the air. Nelson gets under it and will make the catch for out number one.
Designated player number 11, Stephanie Hanick.
Stephanie Hanick steps into the batter's box now with one out, nobody on. Going to get something going here for the Mastodons. Takes strike one on the outside. Hanick so far today drew a walk back in inning number two. Hackey delivers. That one is down low. Now one ball and one strike. And Hackey so far here today has had to deal with a little bit of traffic on the base paths, but 3 1/3 innings. Only given up two hits, no runs. Has walked three, no strikeouts. But he's dealt with the traffic she's kind of created. She's created some problems for herself, but gotten herself out of them, including bases loaded with nobody out and not surrendering a run. Pitch on its way, and that one is low. Makes it three balls and one strike here to Hanick. A 3-1 on its way. That one is off the outside corner. It'll be a five-pitch walk to Hanick. Her second base on balls today. Gets herself to first base here with one out in the inning. So the base runner now for the Mastodons. Need to do some work with it here. Now into the middle innings. Jenna Balthazar will come up now, the number seven batter. One of three left-handed bats in this lineup for German Fairchild. Balthazar, Watson, and Denny, the three lefties in the lineup. First pitch to Balthazar, down low off the ground. Skips in to Mostick behind home plate. Be ball one. One ball and no strikes, and the pitch in, a swing, and Hanick got a piece of that one. Sent it back to the screen. It'll be one ball and one strike. One offering from the freshman Hackey on its way. Swing and a miss up high. Little riser that time to Balthazar, swung through it. Now behind in the count, one ball, two strikes. Hackey's still looking for her first strikeout of the day. The 1-2 offering gets her first strikeout. A swing and a miss there by Balthazar. Now two down for the Mastodons. Hanick still over at first base. Balthazar now 0-2, and he'll bring up Courtney Holm, number eight batter. Holm, the left fielder, swings and follows the first offering from Hackey back to the screen. Aubrey Hackey, a left-handed freshman from Highland, Illinois. Lines and delivers the 0-1. That one's popped up back to the press box here. That one was just about window level, about two doors over to my right. Some members of the Summit League back over here. On almost right into their booth, just to the right of me. Got to bring your glove to the ballpark, no matter where you're at. That one came right over the screen, right back towards us. Next pitch bounces in. These are one ball and two strikes here to Holm. With Hanick over on first base, one stolen base and two attempts so far in the year for Stephanie Hanick if she wants to leave early. One, two offering on its way, swung on and fall right back to the screen by Holm. Hackey, as I was mentioning, the freshman of the year in the Summit League from Highland, Illinois. As I look out on the field, I see she's the only player not wearing long sleeves today. At least for Omaha, that is. Remember the other player for the Mavericks wearing the long black, long sleeve under their jersey, you could say. The Hackey, she's going without it. To tough it out here in the slightly chilly and slightly windy, but not as bad as it could be, weather for Fargo-Moorhead. Two balls, two strikes, and two outs. Deuces Wild on the scoreboard here. Top four, pitch on its way. And that one, left low, fills the count up at three balls and two strikes. If home was to reach, Brooke Immel is waiting on deck. 3-2 payoff pitch, and Immel will get a chance as that one was outside. And two walks this inning for Hackey. Now five walks on the day. I think sooner or later that number continues to mount. Fort Wayne's going to take advantage of it at some point. So far it hasn't cost her yet. But now two runners on here with two outs in the inning. DJ Sanchez out will go into the circle. Jermaine Fairchild will talk it over with Brooke Immel as well, will be coming up, the center fielder. Talk over the hitting strategy here with two on, two out in the inning. DJ Sanchez out of the circle. Looking for one more out this inning from her freshman pitcher. Can tell you it's like Laura Rooker. Junior pitcher from Elkhorn, Nebraska, is the one warming up down there in that bullpen area here for Omaha. Doing it for most of the game, however. So just because he's warming up now does not mean a sign that I think Sanchez wants to take Hackey out or is looking to get Rooker in here. I think just always having another pitcher warm and throwing a couple pitches here and there to keep yourself loose in case things were to go a little haywire here. Two on, two out. A 1-0 offering. That one's left up high. Now two balls and no strikes to Immel, who's proven over the first 2 days here that she is definitely a patient batter. Drew a couple of walks yesterday against Western Illinois. Got on with a hit by pitch as well. Drew a walk earlier today. At least had a three ball count. Now takes a strike here. It's 2-1. Not a great average, just a 163 average for Immel, making her 87th at bat. 14 hits in those 86 at-bats with 9 RBIs, has walked 9 times and struck out 27, but seems to be a little bit different here, and she flies this one out towards right field. Got a little power into that one, but not far enough as Kelly Patterson gets the catch out there just in front of the track. So after the top of the fourth, after 3.5 innings of play, it's going to be 4-0. Going to the bottom of the fourth, Omaha coming up to bat with the 4-run lead. Jessica Nelson will start off the bottom of the fourth inning here for Omaha. 4-run lead already for the Mavericks. Looking to do some more damage here against Bailey Benefield. First offering from Benefield is outside, ball one. And Omaha, through their first three innings, has gotten the leadoff batter on, two out of the three. And both of those times via a walk. One ball, no strikes, and the pitch line back up the middle. That will be at least a single. Nelson makes the turnaround first, but holds up there. Good work by Immel to cut that one off in the gap. But a rocket right up the middle that time from Jessica Nelson. And again, the leadoff batter is on here for the Mavericks. So one runner on as Nelson's on first. He'll bring up Crystal Pablo. Plays first base, bats right-handed, and bats in the eighth spot in the lineup. First pitch to Pablo. The outside will be ball one. Pablo on the year, a 178 average in the eighth spot of the lineup. Does have nine RBIs, struck out 19 times, walked eight. One double and two home runs. One-oh pitch, swung on and popped way up in the air. It's going to be in foul territory with the catcher. Palmigiani calls off Burns coming down from first, and Palmigiani will make the catch in foul territory to retire Pablo. Now one out in the inning. He'll bring up Bartz, the shortstop. Haley Bartz will come up here, batting number nine spot. 0-1 on the day with a pop-up herself for first time up. Shallow center, and Immel is the one that made the catch. First offering to Bartz. He'll swing to the left side. Wilsbacher knocks it down but can't keep it in the glove. Tough play going to her right that time. Would have been a long throw to retire a pretty speedy runner if she had gotten it. Let's see if they give it an error or a hit. Would have been a tough play for Wilsbacher, but she did at least keep it near the infield. But nonetheless, Bartz finds herself on first base going after the first pitch from Benefield. It also allows Nelson to move over to second. So first and second, one away. And back to the top of the order with Mostek. Natalie Mostek squares around. Ball gets away from Palmigiani, and both runners are going to advance. Mostek had turned around, squared a bunt, pulled the bat back. It was a ball, and Palmigiani couldn't handle the pitch that was a little inside, and both runners are kind of taking a hefty lead off of first and second after the pitch was released, because it was going to be a bunt attempt. And once they saw the ball got away at all from Palmigiani, they both wanted to take off. And Nelson got over to third. Throw came to third, but late. And as the throw went to third, Bartz took off for second. It's now one ball, no strikes. Runners on second and third. Chance for Omaha to extend the four-run lead. The pitch lined right to third off of Denny's arm. And she's stunned by that one. Can't come up with it. Didn't make the catch, and then couldn't come up with the ball after that. Could tell because it just hit her arm, and that one stung. She looks to be okay holding the right arm, but Jermaine Fairchild and the athletic trainer are going to go out and check on her, that's for sure. Don't know if it hit her maybe in the shoulder. It might have been in the chest. Definitely on her right side somewhere. It was a hot rocket. They call it the hot corner for a reason. Mostek laid into one and got Denny somewhere on her right side with her arm or chest. She turned around immediately. Thought maybe she was looking for the ball, but didn't see it right away and just couldn't get down and pick something up. And you don't blame her at all. That one had a sting. Again, not the warmest weather here today, so that one's going to hurt a little bit more. Looks like she's going to be okay and at least tough it out. Usually something like that, you just need to walk around a little bit, let the immediacy of the pain kind of relapse, subside, and now that the ball hasn't hit you for a little bit, and give her a few more seconds to kind of walk it off. And Jermaine Fairchild gonna just call for time and go talk to Benefield here real quick as well. She's already out there. Might as well talk to her pitcher now that you got the bases loaded and one out. And a big moment in the game here now too, as Denny wasn't able to make the play there. Omaha already up 4-0. For Fort Wayne, you only got three more innings of at-bats left. Don't want to fall behind by any more than four here. You're dealing with the top of the order, and the freshman of the year, and Aubrey Hackey, who's had two good plate appearances so far, ripped a single in the first inning and lined out to the shortstop, Wilsbacher. That was back in the third, but both times she's put pretty good bat to ball. First pitch is outside, and Benefield falls behind. One ball, no strikes. Hey, Hackey so far this year batting 366. The hit and a run scored here already today. Hits that one out to the left. That one will drop in front of home. They'll hold up Bartz, but Nelson does come in to score, and Hackey delivers with an RBI single out to left. One more run comes in, and it's a 5-0 lead now for Omaha. Everyone moves up a base as well. Bases remain loaded with one out here, and it's going to be Kelly Patterson who will come up for Omaha. Pitch on swing. Patterson lines it foul down the third baseline. Yeah, Bartz over on third, Mostek on second, Hackey on first. Hit to the outfield will definitely score Bartz, and Mostek, very good speed at first. Hackey, pretty good speed over at first. Mostek on second, good speed on second and first here for Omaha. Patterson, a pretty good batter at the plate. Hits that one foul, and it will twist out of play. No balls and two strikes to Patterson. So far, Kelly here today, into a fielder's choice, her first time up in the first inning, but in the third, hit one pretty deep to left center field and got herself a solo home run. 1-for-2 on the day, a hit, a run scored in an RBI. That was her eighth home run of the year. Here's the 0-2 pitch on its way, swing, and that one's, again, foul down the third baseline. Omaha scoring runs in three of the four innings so far, and a hit here from Patterson really break things open. Fisher waiting on deck as well. That one left up high. One ball, two strikes now here to Patterson. So far on the day, Omaha 6-for-10 with runners on base. They're 3-for-6 with runners in scoring position. Pretty good average there, and 4-of-7 with two outs in an inning. That was Fort Wayne's gold in their first game against Western Illinois. They were something like 8-of-14, 8-of-15 with two outs in an inning. And they also were close to 500 with runners in scoring position. They had a lot of two-out rallies with two outs, nobody on, all of a sudden a walk and a couple of hits here or there, and all of a sudden two runs in an inning just like that. They did that a couple of times versus the Leathernecks. Didn't hit very well with two outs in their game earlier today against South Dakota State. And so far here today, it's been more Omaha. Here's Patterson through the left side of the infield. That's going to go out for one. They're going to send in Mostek for two. Back to second, trying to pick off Hackey. She slides back in safely. And Patterson delivers the single through the left side of the infield. Bart scored easily. They sent Mostek. The throw came in. It was cut off. Hackey, the long round of second. Fort Wayne went back to second, trying to catch her in a rundown or pick her off, sliding back. And Hackey got it back in safely. The throw didn't go directly to second. If it had, they would have had her for sure. I believe it was Denny who had the cutoff there in the infield. And looked to second, didn't throw it right away, then got it into second. Not quite in time as Hackey slid back safely. My coaches in Little League used to say, you didn't play a good game if the jersey's still white at the end of it. And Hackey's not going to have a white jersey at the end of the game, sliding back in safely there to second, but going to be worth it if Omaha can advance here. And if they get one more run, they have the eight runs after five, as long as they would shut out Fort Wayne in the top half of the fifth. Now two runners on. That one gets through the left side. Hackey to third. They're going to send her to throw. Coming in is not going to be in time. Hackey is safe. The ball gets away from Pomigiani. That's going to allow two more runners to advance. Patterson will move to third. Fisher over to second. And Savannah Fisher with an RBI single drives in Hackey. And just like that, Omaha has ballooned their lead to 8-0. Slight stoppage here as Omaha makes a pitch running change. Going to bring in Emily Klosterman. Klosterman going to run for Savannah Fisher over at second. And now Emma Dargy up to bat, and already an 8-run lead. And Chancer is still just with one out in the inning, by the way. Benefield struggling to get through the fourth here. Dargy pops it straight up, but back and out of play. Reaches the seats. And there's been enough balls hitting that literally like exact same area that everyone's vacated about a 10-seat by 10-seat radius there in that section of the stands. Oh, and one the count. Pitch to Dargy left up high. One ball, one strike. One ball, one strike to Dargy. He already has a home run and a single here today. Fouls that one straight back. One ball, two strikes. A home run for Dargy came back in the first, then a single back in the third. Has a couple of hits, one run scored, two RBIs. Was her seventh home run of the year. The 1-2, left up high. Evens the count at two balls and two strikes. Pattison, good enough speed at third. She'll score with anything hit to the outfield here. Really any hit at all, as long as it's not something towards third baseman Denny. And also Klosterman over at second, the pinch runner, good speed there. Yeah, I think a hit to the outfield. They'll probably try and send her as well. He was just one out. A 2-2 on its way. Swung on, hit well out there towards left center. Back, but going to hang up in the air and be catchable. Catch out there by Holm. The throw in, not in time. And tagging and scoring is Pattison. Was cut off in the circle that time by Burns. Pattison comes in, tagging from third. So the RBI sacrifice fly from Emma Dargy would be her third RBI of the game. And a 5-run fourth makes it 9-0 Omaha now. Klosterman could not advance on that play. And now two outs, runner on second, and Faith Romero will come up to bat. Romero, the left fielder. 0-2 here today. The first pitch, she's going swinging, hitting one out to left, and that one, if it's fair, is gone. And fair it is, a home run for Faith Romero. The third home run of the game for the Mavericks, and that one's a backbreaker for the Mastodons. 11-0, Omaha. Romero turned it on the very first pitch she saw from Benefield. Hit it hard out to left, and the wind might have helped that one just stay fair a bit. The wind blowing kind of across the field from left to right, out towards right center. And that one didn't stay fair by much, but stayed fair by enough. Clear on the fence, and the home run for Faith Romero right there. Three RBIs makes it 11-0. Or two RBIs on that one, two-run homer. Faith Romero making it 11-0 as her third home run of the season. And RBIs 10 and 11 for her on the year. Now two outs and nobody on. We'll bring up Jessica Nelson. Nelson started off this fourth inning with a single out to right center. Later came around to score. Hits this one on the ground towards third. Denny, nice play to her left. Comes up with it, fires across. Foot was on the bag for Burns, and she able to corral the throw from Denny in time. Out is Nelson. That does it for Omaha in their half of the fourth, but all the damage done. A home run in the inning and a bunch of other runs as well. A 7-run fourth inning for the Mavericks. They're three outs away from moving on to the Summit League softball tournament. They lead 11-0 going to the top of the fifth. Thank you. Fort Wayne with some work to do in their half of the fifth. Been shut out so far by the freshman of the year, Aubrey Hackey. They trail 11 to nothing. It's an eight-run rule after five, so they've got to score at least four runs here to get it down to seven. They're going to have to do it at the top of their order. They're in the right spot. Wilsbacher will lead things off, then Watson and Burns, and they're going to need a lot more after that. Hackey been pretty good so far. Four innings pitch, has five walks, been some control issues, but she's worked herself out of them. Only one strikeout. No runs allowed and just two hits. So she hasn't compounded the walking with giving up hits or any solid contact for that matter. Two balls, one strike here to Wilsbacher. So far 0 of 1, grounded out in the first. That one's still over to Bartz at shortstop and then drew a walk back in the third inning. Ahead though, three balls and one strike. And if you're Fort Wayne, you just need base runners at this point. Loser of this game is done. It is an elimination game. The winner will take on the winner of North Dakota State, South Dakota State tomorrow. And a five-pitch walk to Wilsbacher puts her aboard on first. NDSU and SDSU play tomorrow, 1 p.m. right here at the Ellick Sports Complex. Make sure you tune in on the stream for that one if you can't be here. And then the loser of that game will take on the winner of this one, which looks like it's going to be Omaha. The Omaha, and then the loser of NDSU-SDSU, the winner of that game between the top two seeds, will qualify for the championship, and they'll have to lose twice. Those games will be brought to you on Saturday, the first one at 1 p.m., the second one if necessary. If the team that hasn't lost yet does lose, it will be at 3:30 p.m., and both of those games you can find on ESPN3 and brought to you by Midco SN. This one's hit out to left. That will drop for a single in front of the left fielder Romero in Fort Wayne. Not going down without a fight. The top first two batters reach here for the Mastodons on a walk. And then a Lauren Watson single out to left. Watson now with two singles on the day. They got two on and nobody out. And here come the big bats for the Mastodons. This one is going to be Demetra Burns. First pitch to Burns. He goes after, hits right to short though. Play up second for one over to first. And in time for the double play. Huge double play turn there by Omaha. Burns hit it sharply on the ground. Bart's there to pick it up. Flips to Klosterman. Klosterman with the relay over to Pablo in time to get the double play. And a killer double play right there for Fort Wayne. Trying to get something going here in the fifth. It will bring up Maria Palmigiani. Wilsbacher does advance on the play over to third. And Palmigiani comes up now, but you're hoping she could come up with at least two runners on, maybe even the bases loaded. A chance maybe to hit a big shot somewhere and tie this or get them within eight. Now two outs and Wilsbacher there on third. First pitch was a ball, 1-0. From Hackey to Palmigiani. That ball hit out towards right. Is it going to stay fair? Well, not. It will twist foul. One ball and one strike. Would it hit off the top of the wall? Aubrey Hackey, again, the freshman of the year, been pretty impressive here today. Gotten herself in some sticky situations, gotten out of them. They've always had somebody warming up. This is the first time right now as I look down in that bullpen area. No one warming up here for Omaha. And Hackey spent time as an outfielder and a pitcher here in her freshman year. That one's sharply up the middle, a two-hopper up the middle of the infield. Going to get the first run in for Fort Wayne. As Palmigiani gets the RBI single right up the middle. Drives in Wilsbacher from third. Be the 31st RBI of the season for Maria Palmigiani. Wilsbacher comes in and scores for the 22nd time this year. So Palmigiani will stand in over there at first. Gonna have a pinch hitter here as well for Fort Wayne. Looks like number 18, Amber Davis, senior from Ramona, California, will come in. The pinch hit for Morgan Denny. Denny was one of two on the day. I think this is more of a move from Jermaine Fairchild. Get a senior in there. Last game, get the senior in there. Have her have a chance here to bat. First pitch. Misses for ball one. Denny, just a freshman. That's why I think This Fort Wayne team has a chance, too. You got a freshman in Morgan Denny, looks like a pretty good hitter. You've got a sophomore catcher, Pomigiani. He's a foul under the bullpens. Pomigiani probably a first-team All-Summit League selection next year. The current first-team All-Summit League catcher was the player of the year in Brittany Moore. She's the senior catcher for South Dakota State. She'll graduate this year. And then Pomigiani, who was second-team All-Summit League this year, will, you would think, if she continues on this track, take that spot a year from now. Strike number two there to Davis, the pinch hitter. She's a 152 average on the year, making her 34th at-bat of the season. 1-2 from Hackey. Swung on, hit up towards center. Hanging up in the air, though. Nelson's under it, and Nelson makes the catch. That's going to do it. Omaha wins this one by a final score of 11-1 in five innings. Run rule in effect. And Fort Wayne, with the upset in the early round, couldn't come through here on day number two of the tournament. Get run ruled a couple of times here in Omaha. With that big seven-run fourth inning, get the win today. They'll advance here in the loser's bracket and take on the loser of SDSU-NDSU tomorrow with an impressive 11-1 win. Aubrey Hackey will get the win on the circle today for Omaha. With the win, she'll improve to 6-8 on the season. Her final line today goes five innings. Gives up just the one run. Does have five walks, one strikeout. With the win for Omaha, they will improve to 20-30 on the year, so a 20-win season for the Mavericks now with the win here today. Fort Wayne falls one win shy of that mark. They will fall to 19-35 on the year with the loss. Omaha will play again tomorrow. They'll find out who they're